Hello! How are you doing? Now, when I try to research this beer, I research all the beers I review. I couldn't find that much about this beer. I know there's many variations of the Full House beer from Blackjack Beers, but this beer right here, the Full House Bread Double IPA in red wine barrels, weighing 9%. It's 2016 range of barrel aged beers from Blackjack Beers. But other than that, that's all I've managed to find. I've not managed to find the type of red wine barrel they used. Not managed to find what kind of bread they used. But looking forward to trying it. Now, the many variations of Full House as a different frontal logo, different kinds of Full House. Now, Full House refers to the card game Blackjack and such. Yeah, I think there's one in Pinot Noir, there's one in Whiskey, this is the original one, and there's another one as well. So, now, it does say to best before 3 years from October 2016, so I'm guessing the range began in October 2016. And I'm guessing that's when the barrel started. Barrel is in the beer. But light. Just see a little bit of orange, a little bit of lemon, yellow, there's a bit of a light colour to it. There is still a hop character to it. Now I had a creek in barrel aged and I've had a few wine barrels beers in the past. Now Brett is referring to the I don't know if I've had a lot of Brett IPAs. Might be the first one. Yeah, it's basically the use the remember how to pronounce it. Well, it's like infected beers, but in a good way. And if you remember the early times of the other little yogurts that use natural infections to bring out the goodness in stuff in but. Like I said, I couldn't find that much information. I really should just research the type of beer rather than the beer. Yeah, test. Oh, that's weird. Slight oily texture, as well as almost like a cotton mouth feel. It does have nice texture to it, but it's just a bit too off-putting in parts because It almost has like a witch's kind of taste to it. Now, considering it's kind of really fresh because it's 2017 now in the early parts, so if it is bottled in October 2016, so it's probably about 6 or 7 months. But yeah, when experiencing a new style of beer, you kind of have to pull back a little bit and think. Now, there's some kind of IPA notes to it, and as I've been reacquiring my palate for sour beers and stuff like that, it's nice to try a new style. A British IPA. That's not only a British beer, an IPA, and a barrel aged beer, all rolled into one. So you've got a British IPA, barrel aged beer. And that's a new concept for me. That's why it was a bit difficult trying to research this kind of unique style beer, but then I can't find anything. This is kind of frustrating. So I like to learn about new stuff, especially in the beer world. But for my first British IPA barrel aged, it's quite nice. But like I said, it has a little uniqueness to it that's kind of off-putting, but it's maybe been my first. But one of the first Lancashire beers from Blackjack that I started to really enjoy was Blackjack, and they started out with Cascades, like much more breweries, and now they've gone on to unique beers like this. It's cool. Always push yourself, try and do stuff like I am today with bread. Okay, that's bread marrow. Now, this is the thing. Would you buy it again? For me, yes, because I want to, now I've tried it, I want to try it again so I can build myself on this kind of beer. But if I was familiar with the style, that'd be different because it's kind of weak in the palate. Palette for an IPA, it's kind of weak, the palette for a bread beer, and for a barrel aged beer it's pretty average to above average. But overall it's a above average beer because it kind of balances between average to above average. But a brewery should the information out for its beer, no matter if it's limited to anyway, all that size. Check out Blackjack Beers out of Manchester. You take care.